Should I buy a twin tip or a directional board? It's a question that we get asked all the time. And in this video, I'm going to tell you what a twin tip is, what a directional board is, and then we'll figure out which one's the best for you. We'll start off with my board. It's a Sensor Plus 156. I absolutely love it, and it's a twin tip. I ride mostly park, so I'm going off jumps, rails, and boxes, ride-in switch, land-in switch, taking off regular, taking off goofy. I like to ride a board like this because it allows me to get a good symmetrical feel between the nose and the tail, having a stance that's bang in the middle of my snowboard. If you're like me and love freestyle, whether it's a side hit, buttering or jibbing or in the snowpark, having a twin tip is probably going to be perfect for you. A directional board generally means you're going to have a longer nose and a shorter tail. You're naturally going to be set back towards that tail. And it's going to bring heaps of benefits with that, such as riding powder when you're free riding, or if you're on the piste and wanting a carve and drive through those turns, or if you're on some variable terrain with lots of lumps and bumps, it's going to help you drive all the way through them and maintain balance. We've got heaps of directional boards in the Nidecker range. For example, this one, the Mellow, is a true directional shape, and it even comes with a swallowtail, so it helps you sink that tail when you're riding powder. Another option if you're starting out is a directional twin. It has the feel of a twin shape, but with your stance slightly set back, it has the benefits of a directional board as well. It works great in your natural stance, and it also works fantastic switch, so it's great for the freestyle element. When you want to go over to the free ride and the variable terrain, it also performs great in there as well. A directional twin like the Merc here is a perfect option for all mountain riders, and it's a perfect option for people just starting out as well. As you start to refine your turns and become more fluent on your snowboard, you're going to start figuring out what board you prefer on what days, whether it's a different snow type or different terrain. Let us know in the comments below what snowboard shape you prefer. And also don't forget to hit subscribe to see more helpful tips and guides on the Nidecker channel.